welcome back to another video. It's been a while since my last video, but there's so many things that have happened since the last time I uploaded. I did have my first trip back to Congo since having my son. I was there from December up until the end of January, and it was 2 months of me kind of just getting my bearings again, you know, kind of finding my feet, reconnecting with friends, reconnecting with like my business partners. So it was so important for me to kind of do that behind closed doors. I did have the option to vlog, and obviously what I wanted my channel was to actually be about vlogging, which it will be moving on forward. I just felt like that trip in particular was very like very close to heart in terms of like me just having that confirmation, that clarity, going back with a new perspective, going back with new ideas, going back with a new strategy of how I wanted to do things or how I wanted to progress in terms of like a new vision for my business as well. There was a lot of conversations that needed to be had, you know, behind closed doors before I kind of like came and started telling you guys this one day, blah blah. Also, it was my first trip going back with my son, so it was the first time me taking my son to Congo, and obviously I really just kind of wanted to observe him. So like the first month I kind of stayed at home a lot. Obviously it was the Christmas, New Year's period, so obviously spent a lot of time with family and kind of just observing, seeing okay, I'm okay with being in Congo, I'm okay with being in Africa. And obviously I knew that that's kind of initially like long term, that's where I wanted to kind of settle or kind of spend like the majority of my time or kind of be based in Congo. But it was like, now it's just not about me, it's also about my son. And is my son going to be able to you know, is he going to be able to cope with the sun, the mosquito bites and all of that, different food, different climate in general, just a whole different system. And he was fine, like he was perfect. I had no worries, I had no issues, was having the time of his life, like running around the compound and just like literally like like those that have me on Instagram, have me on Snapchat, kind of saw like the mischief that he was getting up to while he was there. It was actually amazing to start the year there as well, you know, have initial meetings and obviously know kind of finding my bearing as well and kind of deciding like how are we going to move on forward. So it was really good, like really really good. It was such an important time for me in particular as a person, as a businesswoman. The outcome of everything that we do comes down to the decisions we make, and obviously there was very important decisions that I had to make in terms of where I was gonna, you know, how I was going to move on forward and so and so forth. So it was a very enlightening trip for me and for my son as well so yeah. There is a lot of content coming up for my channel in particular, other platforms as well, so it's really exciting to know. Whilst I was away, you know, whilst I had, you know, I was away from YouTube, of course, I did kind of receive a few messages, a few emails. It was nice, really, really nice, honestly, really nice to know that there's people out there that are on the same journey as me in terms of going back, experiencing the culture shock, experiencing this, experiencing that. Those that haven't watched my first videos, which is five top tips, my top tips on how to start a business in Africa for young entrepreneurs from the diaspora. So I'm gonna leave a link to that video in the description box below. And obviously you can see in terms of how I kind of started and how you can also start your journey as an entrepreneur in Africa. And a lot of people reached out to me based on that particular video in terms of what they wanted to do. Also gave me their, you know, what they would say would be a tip for them, even though we did kind of agree on, you know, on most if not all of the five tips. And you know, and it's nice that now is a way that, you know, we can connect and kind of see how we can help each other and obviously answer like common questions amongst ourselves as well, which is nice to have kind of like have this community of entrepreneurs in Africa. it's so nice, because obviously I'm a big advocate of Africa is the future. The time to invest in Africa is now. The diaspora is Africa's biggest asset. So many people, there's thousands and thousands of young entrepreneurs now going back and investing in Africa, and it's so beautiful to see. And hopefully my channel, I'll be able to display a lot, apart from my own journey, also see if I can display other people and other journey, other people on their journey. Especially be nice to have people from different fields, because I'm based in the film and the entertainment industry, so you know, the whole showbiz stuff. So if you do have any questions, do not hesitate to contact me. You can email me, send me a DM, Instagram, Twitter, I'm on Facebook, I'm on LinkedIn, so I'm really across the board, and so that means I'm very accessible as well. Leave any comments in the comment section as well. If you have any questions, it's nice for us to have, you know, to be able to discuss in the comments as well, in terms of everyone's perspective. Like I said, everything that I'll be sharing on my channel is based on my personal experience. I can only give what I have at the end of the day, but also, you know, we're all individuals, we're all different, we're all on a different journey, so it'd be nice for everyone to kind of chip in and share their experiences, for us to be one stronger, more knowledgeable, and also have a nice support system and a strong network as well. Yeah, so don't forget to like, share, comment, also subscribe, because there is a lot more videos to come. Yes, yeah, so I'll see you in my next video.